Welcome at the House of European History. My name is Joanna Urbanek and I am curator of the exhibition Fake for Real, a history of forgery and falsification. We humans have natural predisposition to explore and to try to make sense of the world around us, to understand it better using techniques which are available to us. In the last episode, we spoke about religion. Now, we will concentrate on the fakes and forgeries linked with gradually expanding horizons of the Europeans, from the geographical exploration to the modern science. False travel narratives had long-lasting effects on geographical knowledge, cartography, and expansionist ambitions. Look at those sea monsters. Cartographers and writers often illustrated their works with images of the fantastic creatures allegedly appearing to the sailors. Even Columbus claimed to have seen the mermaids, not as pretty as they are depicted. Did he really believe in what he claimed? We will never find out. This Ortelius map of Asia from the 16th century shows the non-existent Strait of Anian, based on fantastic accounts. In 1609, Lorenzo Ferrier Maldonado promoted the fortification of the Strait of Anian to prevent foreign access to the Spanish Pacific settlements. The existence of the Strait of Anian was debunked only 200 years later. In his travel accounts, published in 1705, Louis Armand de Lantin claimed to have sailed the Long River flowing into the Mississippi. His revelations muddied the maps of North America for almost a century. Lantin's progressive views of Native Americans helped to build his reputation among European intellectuals. Even in the 19th century, Japanese mummified mermaids like this were still presented in curiosity chambers and museums in Europe and America, sometimes with a clear intention to deceive the audience for fame and gain. This one is made of papier-mâché and cotton around a wooden frame, completed with human hair, parts of shark jaws, and fish skin. In the Japanese culture, mermaids were believed to possess mystical abilities and their images to potentially bring good fortune. According to Johann Frederick van Overmeer Fischer, who purchased this object in Japan for his collection of rarities, mermaids were also believed to foretell the future, relevant for local communities. Certain invented narratives of travel affected the entire field of geographical knowledge, including cartography and navigation. Some of them served as propaganda tools for colonial expansion. Some, although fictitious, incorporated the most progressive ideas of their time. George Psalmanzar claimed to be the first native of Formosa, now Taiwan, to visit Europe and published a best-selling and fictionist account about the island. We are keen to affirm our preconceptions. In line with contemporary ideas about foreign cultures, he cultivated an exotic self-image, eating raw meat, sleeping upright, and consuming opium and tobacco in large doses. Gaining allies by converting to Anglicanism, Psalmanzar briefly acquired fame and respect, which he lost when his fraud was ridiculed by other travelers, mainly the Jesuits, who, although not much loved in England, were able to provide more coherent account on Formosa. In his memoirs, Psalmanzar examined his conscience and outlined how he created his scam. He never revealed his true name. It still remains a mystery. The fountain of creativity has not run dry. People continue to search for sites of fantastical, far-off civilizations. From 1989 to 1990 in Belgium, during the so-called UFO wave, several unidentified flying objects were allegedly seen. A famous photograph was even taken of one of them, its maker, Patrick Marshall, later revealing it as a prank. Yet there were other witnesses, some of whom even claimed to have encountered the aliens. We see what we want to see. The invention of the printing press ushered in a new era with information becoming available on an unprecedented scale. but an ever-increasing quantity of information does not guarantee accuracy. Those in pursuit of fame and fortune were happy to spread false information to the audience eager for the breaking news. From 15th to 17th century, intellectuals were arguing about the freedom of publication. Famous philosopher Erasmus was especially critical about the crowd of printers causing confusion everywhere by their publications containing innumerable errors. Yet, it takes one to know one. Despite his critique of misinformation, Erasmus presented his own treatise as the work of an early saint, recently discovered in an ancient library. This collection of works by Saint Cyprian, edited by Erasmus, contains the text De Duplici Martirio, created by Erasmus to support his own religious argumentation. Science, based on empirical research, strives to deliver facts. Yet scientists do leave traces of bias in their work. Others pervert research for personal gain. In 1912, amateur paleoanthropologist Charles Dawson claimed to have discovered bone fragments from the earliest Englishman at Piltdown. Piltdown man soon became part of the canon of human evolution. Dawson's skull combined human and orangutan bones. Scientists who examined the bones were deceived by the forgery as well as by their desire to find in England a worthy counterpart to Germans' Heidelberg man. Only after 40 years the bones were exposed as fakes. Fluorine testing revealed that the Piltdown remains were 50,000 years old at most. Later tests showed that the cranium came from a medieval man and the jaw from an orangutan less than 200 years old. It now appears that two human specimens, possibly from the medieval period, were also used. Analysis of the way in which the bone fragments were assembled suggests a single forger, Charles Dawson. Fraudulent scientific findings can have dangerous, even deadly consequences. An article published in The Lancet in 1998 claimed that there was a link between a popular MMR vaccine and autism. 12 years later, the study was retracted. The research was deemed fraudulent, the result of misrepresented data and scientific misconduct. However, by the time the study was removed from the scientific records, it had already triggered the global anti-vaccination movement. The history of scientific research exhibits willful forgeries. The possibility of being proven false is not a defect of the scientific method, but an essential quality that differentiates it from other systems of making sense of the world. What is crucial, however, is the accuracy and the speed in disseminating knowledge, and our critical mind to be always ready to learn and change our opinion.